So Jafar is now a hottie and Jasmine has a bestie? Yes, Disney has made some head-scratching casting and story announcements about their live-action Aladdin adaptation, which seem to significantly alter the context of the character of Jasmine specifically. And here's how. But first off, I am glad that Marwan Kenzari has landed one of the few lead roles for actors of Middle Eastern descent these days in Hollywood blockbusters. They're all in Disney's live-action Aladdin. But by casting not just a hottie, but a relatively young hottie, they drastically change the character and Jasmine's interactions with him. Suddenly, it would seem that hypnosis isn't necessary to convince the Sultan that his most trusted advisor might be the best husband for his daughter. I mean, remember? It was the thought of Jafar's age which almost overcame the hypnosis in the original animated movie. And when Jasmine kisses Jafar to distract him in the big finale, I think that maybe instead of being grossed out, Aladdin might be genuinely worried that Jafar is a actual romantic rival for Jasmine, who could be hedging her bets in case, you know what, Aladdin doesn't win the day. I bet, in fact, this new version of the kiss will haunt Aladdin for the rest of the marriage. Every time they get into a fight, he was like, "You liked that kiss, didn't you?" And she's like, "Leave me alone." And then she's like, and then she like goes and storms off in her room and she's like, "Did I? Would I be fighting with Jafar this much? Who knows?" Because they don't seem to be friends anymore either. I hope that none of this is true. But on that note, let's go to Jasmine's new BFF and confidant, played by SNL's Nasim Pedrad. And I know that some of you have pointed out that this is a character who's been introduced in some other versions from Disney, like for instance, the Broadway play. And I think in the movie, it would seem that maybe Disney hopes this will be like a Josh Gad type character, with a, it's as if they cast Bobby Moynihan as LeFou. And I don't think that would have worked out as well. But you know what? I'm willing to give Nasim Pedrad the benefit of the doubt. But you know what? On a side note, if they're trying to go for a LeFou here with Nasim Pedrad, is Jafar so supposed to be Gaston? Because that did work out quite well. But not all villains should be hot. I mean, Gaston, his being hot was supposed to be unique, story-specific commentary for Beauty and the Beast on physical versus inner beauty. You just can't go having hot villains all the time now, who would not only not work in the other stories, but I think it would cheapen what Gaston was supposed to illustrate. Jafar, on the other hand, is all about the corruption of a mad quest for power versus Aladdin's diamond in the rough. So you don't want to turn Jafar into an Arabian Gaston, or maybe like Jack Sparrow with animals on their shoulders. Anyway, Pedrad is playing Mara, Jasmine's comedic handmaiden and friend. Because, you know, people who work for you or even serve you are totally legit friendships. But in order for the Aladdin live action movie to pass the Bechdel test, always a worthy goal, will it, as a result, undercut Jasmine as a character? That's what I'm really worried about. So allow me to explain, because when I tweeted this, some of you were triggered. But this is a specific situation. Something that is like good in like conversation, like that's the thing about like social awareness. It can't be a blanket thing because sometimes it doesn't work. Like this one, for instance, Guy Ritchie is directing this movie. If there was a different director, maybe I'd have a little more confidence in this. But Guy Ritchie's track record with female characters is absolutely horrible. But you know what he loves? Do you know what he excels at? Bromances. So my fear is that Mara exists to give Jasmine someone to talk to while Aladdin and Genie go off on their own. They're like, "Hey, audiences, don't feel bad that we've left Jasmine back at the palace because she's hanging out with Mara. You don't want Mara to be alone, do you? They're gonna talk girl talk." And that reminds me of those get-togethers that still happen to this day where men and women will go into separate rooms because, hey, it's not like men and women have shared interests that they can talk about. I mean, even one of you even said when I tweeted about this that my insistence that Jasmine and Aladdin be friends was putting Aladdin in the friend zone. And yes, the friend zone is a horrible place, but its existence doesn't mean that friendship and romance are opposing relationships that can't coexist. The friend zone overlaps with healthy romantic relationships. And some people I have heard have escaped from the friend zone. Now, Jasmine was not just the first Disney princess to wear pants. But that was indicative of, I mean, you just can't put the pants on. It's evidence of a larger personality and character trait, which was on full display with Jasmine because she was the first to be equal partners with her love interest. Aladdin didn't just love Jasmine. She ended up being his best friend, which was reinforced by the sequels and the animated series. And one of the best things about the Aladdin stories is that Jasmine is always right there next to him during his adventures. And he wants her there. Never once, although I could totally see this being a Guy Ritchie mentality, he's like, Jasmine will not go away. Sometimes we just want to have a bros night out. And I would feel really bad for Jasmine. I guess she can complain to Mara about it. and Mara can comedically say, men, and let's reinforce unhealthy relationships instead of depicting one of the healthiest romantic relationships ever in a Disney animated movie and just in general. Now, something, by the way, that wasn't repeated in Disney films, animated films, until Tangled. And as one of you pointed out when I tweeted about this, in the new Tangled animated series, they've given Rapunzel a new BFF, who, by the way, also works for her. Why can't these women make legitimate friends? It's important that people be equals when they interact. I think it's important. Do you want to come out? Or do you want to come over and, like, talk? And it's like, there's always going to be that, did you just come over because you worked for me or my dad or my parents? That relationship with Rapunzel's new BFF has come at the cost of her relationship with Eugene. Now, she and her new BFF do all this stuff. Eugene's like, why'd you leave me back here? And, you know, whoever is the lead character is the one who stays in the story and gets the more screen time. So, because it's Tangled, it's all about Rapunzel. And if it's called Aladdin, that means it's all going to be about Aladdin and Will Smith. And, Jasmine's going to be sitting with Raja and Mara being like, how the hell did this happen to me? Now, finally, for both Jasmine and Rapunzel, something else that's important is that these princesses were trapped, one by tradition, one literally. But Aladdin and Flynn Rider, aka Eugene, offered escape not just physically, but also emotionally and mentally. And before any of you say, hey, that's really unhealthy, you know, they shouldn't have their whole worlds revolving around these men, I'd like to point out that, again, it was really crucial to these stories that these guys viewed these women as their equals. They weren't just like, okay, I'll let her tag along in the hopes that we can hook up. They genuinely enjoyed their company. Although Tangled did start as like a bickering, meet cute kind of movie. But anyway, you get the idea and you know where it ended up. So to give either a friend, Jasmine or even Rapunzel, especially a comedic one, significantly lightens the direness of their situations that's supposed to be, you know, really important to their stories. So I'm all for hot guys in movies and for female characters having best friends who are genuine friends and not employees, if it serves the story and the lead characters. Again, these can't be blanket statements. So in this case, with live action Aladdin, it would seem that this is not a good idea. I hope that we're pleasantly surprised. But I'm curious, what are your thoughts? What were your thoughts when you first heard this? What are your thoughts now that we've discussed it? Be sure to leave your comments down below, and you can check out some more videos right now.